Right, guys, I have delved on this subject in the past, but a few people have asked me to just go a little bit deeper. So, how can we form a mix when we're not really doing a mix? Now, let's imagine our terminology of a mix is beat matching the tracks. So, for example, one tune is at 120 BPM, and the other one is at 120 BPM. We keep them in key, or keys that match, work well together, and we beat match them, keeping in time, or into consideration bars, phrases, count of one, bringing it in on the one, etc. Not overlapping too much melody, vocals, making it a nice sort of transition. Something that sounds sweet. Now that is your stereotypical mix. Let's imagine though that we need to mix a couple of tracks, but as there is a lot of people out there who cannot, for love nor money, beat match. How do you get a smooth mix? Now a smooth mix does not necessarily mean you have to beat match it. In other words, it does annoy me when people go, oh, you're crap at beat matching, you can't mix, or you're... It's like, that's absolute rollocks. And by the way, rollocks are items that you have on a boat and they keep the oars in place. It's got nothing to do with bollocks that are between your legs and keep your legs in place. Right. Anyway, so what I'm going to do here, I've got a couple of tracks to explain how we can do a mix. This one here is Pryda, it's called Armed, and it's a beautiful tune, it's from 2007. And this one here is a remix of Adamski Killer. So first of all, what we'll do, we'll listen to the beginning of Adamski Killer. All right, first of all, or second of all, because I said first, there's no beat there. But there is timing. Now have a listen to this. I'm going to count. One, two, three, four. One, three, two, three, four. Two, three, four. Three, four. One, two, 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 three, four. Four, one, two, fish and chips, Rice Krispies, beans and Smarties. All right, so we had timing. Now let's have a listen to the end of the track. There's still timing. Again, as I've said many times before, generally, or 99.9% of the time, with modern day dance music, electronic styles of dance music, the BPM will never change during the course of the music. You do have a few odd exceptions where the remixer will intentionally slow down the track or speed it up. For example, Little Louis French Kiss, put underneath there in comments other tracks you know of that speed up or slow down. So let's have a listen to this guy here. Right. And also, at the end of this video, just check out the lickable clinks in the description. If you are familiar with children, mothers and fathers, and you have the attitude that children should be able to see both parents, then follow the links and see what you think, okay? Right, listen to this. Here we go. Believe it or not, we still have a beat there. There is still timing. So, what we can do is we can, I'm going to class as meld, as gel. Two tracks together. We're not going blurred, are we? Ah, we're still there. We're going to actually gel that track with that track, but we're not going to beat match them. I'm just going to like bung that one in at the latter part of that one. Also, what I could do is if I, of course, have effects, which I do on this mixer. If you have effects, you can then enhance the mix or maybe tweak it slightly so the people listening, watching, dancing can't distinguish between that mix. If you do it correctly, it can sound fantastic. So what we'll do, we'll go to the end of this track here. Right, I'm going to pause it there, and I'm going to get to the beginning of this one. Right, bearing in mind, I haven't got any headphones. It's not really necessary when you're doing this kind of a mix, because you're not really beat matching. What you do need to make sure is that you've got it at the point on this, the point of the get it out, son. You got it. So yeah, you're at the, oh dear. You're at the point at which you know this track will work well with that track. So. Let's get an echo on there quickly before it goes. Bring it out. Now, I promise you, done correctly, that will not make the dance floor leave. In fact, quite often, a mix like this is far superior to a very straightforward beat mix. This is a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful tune. Go Google it. Practice and enjoy. Check out the Lickable Clinks. And you know what? I love all my kids. Practice and enjoy. Thank you. From the bottom of my heart.